Good morning, guys. Lillian with Lily Ray's Collection. Today we are going to be drawing and coloring this Eastern bluebird right here. I've already sketched him out. I do have him on my iPad, so I'm going to be looking at that reference. I'm going to be using, I received this from my I'm never prepared. My smart art box. This came in it, and these are watercolors from Germany, and they are opaque. So I'm going to give this a try. I'm going to use my water brush as well as my palette here, and then these are my Tombow markers that I will be using. So I'm going to put these in front of me to get them out of the way. And I do have to use these are my Royal and Langnickel Aqualon. This is Royal Aqualon Wisp. And so these are specialty brushes. This is 1/4. This one is 3/8. And this one is 1/2. So I'll be using this for the feathers. All right, and here is the sketch. And I'm going to be doing this on time lapse. So, and then in the video, after editing, I'll slow it down somewhat so that you're able to follow it. All right, so let's get started. I do have my spray bottle here. And I think I'm going to start with my watercolors. Let's see how these fare. If I could get it open, it would be nice. Let's see. There we go. Good call. Good gosh. Okay. So I'm going to start with the wooden background. So I'm going to go ahead and use my watercolor brush to wet everything. And remember, the water is only going to go where you, on the items that you wet. They are working outside, so you may hear some noise. I hope it's not too loud. These are going to be brown sticks anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and wet that as well. I'll just be careful going around them. Okay. Actually, I do need this. Let me see. I want to use the brown. This looks like a brown green. Again, this is the first time I'm using these watercolor, this watercolor palette. I'm going to combine, I believe it's red, green, and blue to make a brown and see if I get a better brown than this, because I don't like the way this brown looks. But I'll do that in my second go around. Let's just get this down. And I went ahead and drew in my shadows. Okay, so for now, we're going to leave it like that. And I'm going to go ahead and do the darker brown so that we could put it in here in the center of this hole. So I'm going to go ahead and use, actually maybe I should move my palette on this side. Not a lot of room here. Okay, maybe I could move to this side. And put my palette here. Okay. Let's go ahead and use not brown. Hello. Supposed to be blue. This looks like a phthalo blue. Blue. Red. And yellow. I'm going to use a bright yellow. I don't have the color information, just that it's a yellow. Looks like a lemon yellow. I think I want to put more blue in that. So I'm going to use this blue again. And then red. And then our yellow here. Let's see. My lighting here, let me see. That actually looks like a dark green. That doesn't look like a brown there. I'm gonna use it anyway inside this hole here. It'll deepen the color inside. I'm just learning how to mix colors, so because I understand that they're more vibrant when you mix them yourself, as opposed to having them in the palette. The only thing with that is that you have to remember. We'll let that dry. I'm gonna go ahead and put you on time lapse because this is going to take a while. So I will meet you back here. Okay guys, I think we are done with this piece. I'm happy with the way it came out. Now I'm going to sign it. And I hope you enjoyed the video. And I will see you soon with another bird episode. I love my birds. All right, guys, leave any questions or comments that you may have below. Take care.